And Congress loyalist Jayanti Natarajan has written a scathing letter to party president Sonia Gandhi, claiming that the Congress vice president Rahul Gandhi was micromanaging policy decisions during UPA 2. She says she was asked to quit by the then Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, and was told she was needed for party work. But the next day, she claims her sources told her that Rahul Gandhi's office was calling the media and, quote unquote, planting stories that her resignation was not for party work. She further claims there was tremendous pressure on her from the cabinet, colleagues and industry to clear big ticket projects. That's the latest at this moment. In fact, that letter is on your screen at this moment, the letter that she has written to the Congress President Sonia Gandhi. It's a very, very long letter, detailed letter, which reflects her, in a way, her pain and agony as far as the party is concerned. Also, what we are getting to hear is that she could, in fact, resign from the primary membership of the Congress party. Let's quickly go across to Ashar Ahmed Khan as well as Atir Khan, who are joining us on this big breaking story. Ashar, I'll come across to you first. What's really the story? What's happening in the Congress?
Well, this is an old thing which is happening between the old guard and the new guard. This specific letter categorically states that the office of the Congress vice president, that is Rahul Gandhi, was micromanaging things, was doing things which they wanted to be done in a certain way, and that is why things came to such a level where they have reached now. But the other important point is, which Jayanti Natarajan makes in a letter, that she had been seeking appointment from Rahul Gandhi at various intervals of time, which did not happen. Now, in fact, many leaders also say this, that it is very difficult for people to get an appointment with Rahul Gandhi. So that is one thing which has been going on. Secondly, she's also written in her letter that she was also trying to meet the Congress president, also the vice president, to go ahead and present her side of the story, which was not allowed to be present. Nobody spoke to her, nobody met her. In fact, the entire treatment which was met out to her in the last couple of months was something she could not live with, and finally she is writing this letter. In fact, this is a 2 month old letter. This was written sometime in November, so she's waited about, say, 2 months to 3 months before coming it out to the media. And now what we expect is that she will be doing a press conference. At this point of time, her position within the Congress party will definitely be untenable. So what we are learning from our sources is that she would be putting in her papers as far as the membership of the Congress party is concerned, but we'll have to wait and watch what happens at 12:30.
All right, Ashar, Atir, do stay on with us. We have BJP leader, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao, on the phone line with us. Mr. Narasimha Rao, thanks very much for speaking to Headlines today. Your initial reactions to this letter, explosive letter, rather, of Jayanti Natarajan?
No, I think one always harbored the suspicions as to how a junior minister heading the environmental ministry could hold up projects worth thousands of crores. And now it comes out. And we all always did. It was believed to be some kind of a Jayanti tax, which was what was being talked about openly in corporate circles. Now it turns out this was actually a Rahul Gandhi tax. And Rahul Gandhi was actually instrumental in stalling projects in the environmental ministry, obviously, with the motive of pressurizing the corporate sector to pay up to get clearances. I think there cannot be any greater incidents and evidence of corruption by the Congress's leadership involved in a series of scams. I think this possibly is the direct evidence that you are getting. And I hope there will be more details that will come out as she starts squealing and speaking out.
Mr. Rao, it is your party which is in government at this moment. There are certain apprehensions, there are certain doubts that have been addressed in this particular letter of Jayanti Natarajan as far as clearances are concerned and other issues are concerned. You are in power right now. Would you seek a sort of an investigation as to what exactly happened at that point? Whether any undue benefit was awarded to any company or not?
No, I think we will certainly wait to really let us wait for a day or two to get more details in this regard. And what we certainly expect the Congress party to do today is to hold a press conference where Rahul Gandhi should address the media and not the minions of the Congress party and tell the people of the country why he was involved in influencing a critical ministry like Environment Ministry, and if he had really an involvement or interest in the ministry, why did he not take up the job himself rather than pressurizing and arm twisting the ministers in the government?
Mr. Rao, my only simple question to you is that you are saying that now it turns out that the Jayanti tax that we were all aware of, or even Prime Minister Modi, when he was campaigning for the Lok Sabha elections, did mention, didn't make a mention of Jayanti tax. It turns out that this could perhaps be Rahul Gandhi tax. That's what you are saying. Don't you think that because you are in power now, you should initiate an inquiry and find out what actually it was?
We will respond to this question. This government wants accountability from not only its current government, current ministers. It also wants accountability from the previous regime. Okay, so but I'm saying this report has appeared in the papers this morning. We are likely to get more details today, and we wait for the Congress party's reaction. Rahul Gandhi, I think for a change, Rahul Gandhi is currently in India. He's been seen in the last 2-3 days in India, in Delhi. So I expect him to come before the media today and explain his position on all these issues. And if they fail to do so, and if the charges, if the information that is made available, evidence made available by Jayanti Natarajan is concrete, certainly a follow-up action would follow.
Okay, thanks very much. Appreciate you joining us, Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao, saying that a follow-up action can be expected from this present political dispensation. Let me quickly go back to Ashar Khan joining us from the Congress Party headquarters. Ashar, you were making a mention about the fact that the Congress is going to clarify its position at some time around 12:30. Can you tell us what really, because this matter has been going on for a while now, do we know what really the Congress Party's strategy is going to be as far as Jayanti Natarajan is concerned? This letter is old, as you mentioned, November, if I'm not wrong.
Well, Sanket, at 12:30, I said that there is going to be a press conference by Jayanti Natarajan in Chennai. Okay. The Congress party's press briefing is scheduled for 4:15 p.m. later in the day. So what we are expecting is that the spokesperson of the Congress party, that is Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, would be addressing the press conference. In fact, when we spoke to him right now, he said that he would be going through the contours of the letter and then reacting officially about this. Clearly, the Congress will deny all these facts because they will say that nothing of this sort happened. It was incumbent on the minister concerned to come out and speak. But apart from that, there is a larger issue which is plaguing the Congress party as of now, which is that there are leaders who are speaking out, there are leaders who are disgruntled with the top leadership. Now, that is coming out in the open, and that is something which is very serious because it is, after all, the Gandhis who kept the party united in the last 10 to 15 years. There have been no coups within the Congress party since the Congress president, that is Sonia Gandhi, became the Congress president. But if these things go on, certainly we can expect that there will be more people coming out and speaking in the days to come.
Absolutely, Ashar. Do stay on with us, and Aathir is also with us. We'll come across to Aathir now to perhaps understand why has Jayanti Natarajan chosen this particular time. The point that Ashar is actually mentioning, that this is an old letter, but this issue relates to the time when UPA was actually in power. Welcome back to First Up. Let's in fact now go across to Aathir Khan, who's now joining us. Aathir, we are in fact tracking this scathing letter that Jayanti Natarajan has actually written to the Congress president. It's of course dated back to November 2014. But just take us through this critical point that a lot in the Congress are actually talking about. Why raise these points now?
Absolutely. You see, she's used very strong words like sentenced to death, and her loyalty has been disregarded. Her career has been ruined. She also goes on to say that she was made to speak against Narendra Modi, against her wishes in the Snoop Gate matter when she was a minister at that point of time. And she said if she made it an issue, it would be the government's point of view. She also... So the letter clearly brings out the bickerings within the Congress, and as you, Ashar was pointing out, the timing of the letter absolutely raises several questions. It's just ahead of Delhi Assembly elections, and also, you see, the Tamil Nadu Assembly elections are, they are due. So one keeps one wondering, the strong use of words in these letters, is there a possibility of her resigning from Congress and joining BJP cannot be ruled out at this point of time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Especially at a time when many senior leaders of the Congress party have joined the BJP, Krishna Thirath being one such example of a union minister in the UPA joining the Bharatiya Janata Party. Could that be the case? We'll in fact know when 12:30 Jayanti Natarajan holds a press conference and explains her side of the story, and then eventually the Congress gives its side of the story. Short break at this moment. Do remember, India Today Group has formally launched its initiative.